If you have peripheral neuropathy and you're still relying on medications but not getting real relief, or if you're worried your nerve pain is only getting worse, or even if it feels like no one truly understands what you're going through, that's exactly why I made this video. I'm going to show you how engaging your brain in the right way may help rebuild your nerves and support real healing. Most treatments for peripheral neuropathy focus on pain management, but here's what almost no one is talking about. Your brain plays a direct role in healing your nerves. And if you're not engaging it in the right way, you could be missing a major opportunity to support myelin repair and real nerve recovery. In this video, I'm going to show you 5 science-backed brain tricks that will help rebuild myelin without medication. These are simple, practical strategies that activate your nervous system in ways traditional treatments completely overlook. And if you stay until the end, I'll share the one mindset shift that makes all of these techniques far more effective. Most people never hear this, and it could be a game changer for your recovery. Let's get into it. Hi, I'm Dr. Ole Olson, America's neuropathy coach and founder of Asuta Health Neuropathy Centers. At Asuta Health, we help you heal peripheral neuropathy naturally so you can move, feel, and live better because you matter. Before we get into the 5 brain tricks, it's important to understand why you're focusing on myelin in the first place. Myelin is the protective coating around your nerves. Think of it like an insulation on a wire. It helps these nerve signals travel quickly and accurately throughout your entire body. When you have peripheral neuropathy, the myelin, that protective coating around your nerves, often gets damaged or breaks down. This causes nerves to misfire or slow down, leading to symptoms like pain, numbness, tingling, and even muscle weakness. Most treatments only aim to manage the pain, but if you're not supporting myelin repair, you're not addressing the root cause. That's what makes these brain-based strategies so powerful. Emerging research shows that specific cognitive techniques can stimulate your nervous system in ways that promote myelin regeneration and improve nerve function. In this video, we'll explore 5 science-backed brain techniques that may aid in rebuilding myelin, giving you proactive steps toward better nerve health. Let's go ahead and start with the first one. The first one is visualization techniques. Engaging in mental imagery of physical movements can activate neural pathways associated with those actions, potentially promoting myelin repair. By vividly imagining specific movements, you stimulate the corresponding areas in the brain, encouraging neural activity that supports myelination. Dedicate about 10 to 15 minutes daily to visualize performing activities that you enjoy or that you aim to regain, such as walking, dancing, golfing, or playing an instrument. Focus on the sensations and the movements involved to effectively engage the relevant neural pathways. Research indicates that neural activity can promote brain plasticity through myelin growth. A study from Stanford University found that activity-dependent changes in the cells that insulate neural fibers, the myelin, can enhance brain plasticity, suggesting that engaging in mental imagery could support myelin repair. Number 2, be present. Practicing prayer and meditation does more than just calm your mind. It may also play a direct role in supporting myelin repair and brain plasticity. By focusing your attention and bringing awareness to the present moment, you help regulate stress and create the right conditions for your nervous system to heal. Being fully present has been shown to produce structural changes in the brain, including increased density in areas linked to self-regulation and improved connectivity in white matter, where much of the brain's myelin is actually located. These changes may support the regeneration and protection of myelin, especially in individuals managing chronic nerve conditions like peripheral neuropathy. Start with just 10 to 15 minutes of daily awareness and prayer practice. Sit comfortably, close your eyes, and focus on your breathing. When your mind starts to wander, gently bring it back to your breath and focus on all of your senses. What sort of sounds are you hearing? What are you smelling? What are the feelings that you are experiencing? Just to be fully aware. Research published in Frontiers in Psychology shows that prayer and meditation is associated with enhanced white matter integrity, suggesting potential benefits for myelin health and neural repair. Now, let's move on to the next brain-based strategy. This one gets your neurons firing in a completely different way. Cognitive challenges. Challenging your brain with new and engaging tasks isn't just good for mental sharpness. It may also support myelin maintenance and repair. When you stimulate your brain with learning and problem solving, you increase neural activity in key regions of the brain, which engages your brain to strengthen and protect the pathways that it uses most. Activities like solving puzzles, playing memory games, learning a new language, or even picking up a musical instrument can activate multiple brain areas. This type of sustained mental effort has been linked to increased myelin production, especially in circuits involved in learning and motor coordination. Dedicate at least 15 to 20 minutes a day to an activity that challenges your brain. Try crosswords or Sudoku, language learning apps, or even learning a new hobby that requires coordination. The key is consistency and gradually increasing the complexity to keep your brain adapting. Studies have shown that learning new practical skills is associated with myelin growth, helping to reinforce the neural pathways that are involved. Additional research supports that regular mental stimulation promotes structural changes in the brain that may help preserve and regenerate myelin. Now, let's explore a technique that taps into both emotion and movement, music. Number four is music therapy. Listening to or actively participating in music can stimulate various brain regions involved in movement and coordination, potentially supporting myelin health. Music therapy has been shown to introduce structural changes in the brain, which may aid in the repair of neural pathways and myelin regeneration. Research has demonstrated that neurological music therapy leads to structural changes in the brains of patients with traumatic brain injury, correlating with improved executive function. Additionally, research indicates that music therapy can enhance brain activity in areas related to motor and cognitive functions, suggesting a role in functional rehabilitation. Incorporating music therapy into your routine may involve listening to music that you find enjoyable and calming, or engaging in musical activities such as playing an instrument or singing. These activities can provide a non-invasive and enjoyable way to potentially support myelin repair and overall nerve health. If music can reshape the brain through rhythm and emotions, this next technique takes it a step further by teaching your brain to regulate itself in real time. Let's take a look at how neurofeedback may actually support myelin repair and improve nerve function. Number five, neurofeedback training. Neurofeedback is a non-invasive technique that enables individuals to gain control over their brain activity by providing real-time feedback. This method involves monitoring brainwave patterns and presenting the information to the individual, allowing them to learn and how to modulate their activity consciously. During neurofeedback sessions, sensors are placed on the scalp to measure electrical activity in the brain. This data is then displayed through the visual or auditory cues, helping individuals to recognize and adjust their brainwave patterns. By practicing this self-regulation, individuals may promote neural efficiency and potentially support myelin repair processes. Research indicates that neurofeedback training can lead to structural changes in the brain, including alterations in white matter integrity. Neurofeedback may influence neuroplasticity, which is crucial for myelin regeneration. Consider exploring neurofeedback training under the guidance of a qualified practitioner. This intervention may help you develop better control over your brain activity, potentially supporting myelin repair and improving nerve function. By incorporating neurofeedback training into your routine, you may enhance your brain's self-regulation capabilities, offering a proactive approach to supporting myelin health and managing peripheral neuropathy symptoms. Now that you've learned five powerful brain-based techniques that may support myelin repair, there's one more piece that can make or break your progress. And it has nothing to do with what you do and everything to do with how you think. If you're living with peripheral neuropathy, you already know how exhausting it can be. The burning, the tingling, the frustration of trying treatments that don't work, it wears you down. And after a while, it's easy to feel stuck, to lose hope, or to start thinking that healing just isn't possible. But here's what most people never hear. Your mindset directly impacts how your nervous system responds to healing. When you approach your recovery with the belief that progress is possible, even slowly, even imperfectly, you create the neurological conditions for change. This doesn't mean ignoring your symptoms or pretending everything's fine. It means shifting from "this will never work for me" to "what's one small thing that I can do today to support my healing?" That shift helps calm the sympathetic nervous system, engage the parasympathetic system, and make your brain more responsive to the very strategies we just covered. So take a breath. You're not broken. Your body is trying, and your effort, no matter how small, matters. Keep showing up. Keep stacking these habits, and most importantly, keep believing that healing is possible, because it is. Healing from peripheral neuropathy isn't a straight line. It's a journey. Some days are harder than others. Some progress is slow. But if you've made it this far in the video, it tells me something important, that you haven't given up. You're here, you're learning, you're taking action, and that alone puts you ahead of where you were yesterday. You don't need to be perfect. You just need to keep showing up for yourself, one small shift at a time. That's how change happens. That's how nerves heal. That's how hope builds momentum. So if you found this video helpful, if even one idea made you feel a little more hopeful, a little more empowered, please like and share it. Not just for you, but for someone else who's searching for answers and needs to hear this information. This channel is here to support you, and I'm here to remind you that you are not alone. Healing is possible, and you deserve to feel better, because you matter. Let me know in the comments which brain trick you're going to try first. I'd love to hear your story. And if you're looking for more exercises to increase blood flow to your entire foot, check out my video, 5 Best Neuropathy Blood Flow Exercises. It's my most watched video, and you can watch it here next.